Ms. Klein, well, I appreciate so much the gentleman from Tennessee. He just answered a ton of questions for me about his understanding of props and theatrics by his study of drama in his higher education, because now we understand a lot of things. But also, we have another thing. Folks who study drama also understand you read the lines. They can read the transcript. Quit saying, I want you to do me a favor. It's not in the transcript. It must be hard to read. I guess me and us gets confused when you're trying to make up facts. That's what's happening here. But he also just proved my point why Mr. Jordan's article is actually, the amendment is actually good, because it's what I have said all along. The moment I saw that they decided to use abuse of power, what they did is they gave their whole conference carte blanche to make up anything they want and call it abuse of power, because they don't have anything else to give. They don't have actual crime that they can add up. If they did, as was portrayed from the gentleman from Maryland and so many others, if you had the crime, if you had it, you were longing to put it, you had to put it in the articles. You didn't do it. But then the last thing that is amazing to me, and the gentleman from Tennessee said it, he called the Mr. Zelensky a politician and an actor in a derisive way, basically implying politicians lie. Well, we've seen that this morning, even in just what they're talking about, how they can't even read a transcript, and that he's an actor. It's amazing to me how we on this committee are degrading Mr. Zelensky in the eyes of his country and in the world, because we can't make a case against this president. This is the tragedy of this impeachment right now, is they're trying to degenerate because they can't make the fact that he felt pressured. That is the critical element of their case. I yield back to Mr. Klein.